Okay, hi everyone, and welcome back to my shop. Today on my table is Makita HR2811FT with changeable tool holder. Okay, what we will change for it? It will be the cylinder, the hammer, the sleeve, oil seals, some O-rings, ring spring, and one screw. Okay. So now you hear everything is okay, so we'll not do anything with it. Okay, what was wrong with this one? It was the tool holder broken. Normally it's a hammer inside, so, and it looked like this. Now it's broken. So okay, of course we need to replace it. Okay, I'm replacing the hammer in the sleeve here with a new one. So, just putting them on. Okay, throwing this one away. Of course, it will be the oil seal here. Don't forget it. Okay. Sorry, I'm sick a little bit. So, okay, it's a ring here. You need to remove it and put it on a new cylinder. A groove here goes like that. Okay, of course, just make sure that the ring spring is all in a groove. Okay, now we need to take out the other hammer parts. As you can see, it's a spring ring here. We have two holes, so we need to use them to push the ring spring out. I will try to do that with a screwdriver. Of course, it's not always going with a screwdriver. So. Okay, I will try to hit to some parts inside to take them down. And now I will try to remove the ring spring. Okay. I still can't do that. We'll try with a bigger screwdriver. Of course, be careful. Not hurt your hand. Okay, it's not going. Okay, it's not going, so it's not a big problem for us. Okay, I will try to adjust the camera to the vise. Okay. That seems good. So we need a hammer. There's some kind of puncher. Okay, I will take the smaller one for the beginning. I don't know, it's a. Okay, so 1 millimeter. Okay, 2.8 millimeters, so almost 3. Okay, putting this one on the vise. And hitting the ring spring with the puncher. Or hitting from the both sides. Okay, it's going out, so okay, so now I will adjust the camera back to the normal view. Okay. So now I think it's a normal view of the camera. Okay, just see all the table. Okay. So now the spring ring is going out, so I need to push this part down. The easiest way to use the puncher. Then of course the hammer. Okay, so now we can take the spring ring with the pliers. Okay, of course it's damaged, but I have the new one. Okay. So we can see that the old part here. Okay, so holding ring over there, it's so, but it's the holder is all, it's all one body. Okay, so we don't need it. Now we have this part. It's an O-ring inside. Now I can see that it's cracked. Okay, maybe not proper screwdriver. I will take the tank tool hook. I really love these hooks, they are really great for doing the job like this, and of course they are not expensive. I think they cost less than 20 euros, so really not too much for the good thing. Okay, so as we can see, the O-ring here is cracked, so definitely we need to replace it. Okay, it's good that we have the one. Just pushing it in with the fingers. Now it's in. Okay, so I have the ring spring here, the new ring spring or spring ring, fuck, I don't remember. Okay, it's a rubber here, of course we need to check it for the cracks. Now it looks good. That's second sleeve, so okay, it's good. So now, okay, about the O-ring, the second O-ring goes to the striker. Okay, so okay, now we can start to assemble it. I will start from the cylinder. Okay, well, assembling, I have the spare parts view here, so it's a lot easier to do that. Of course you can disassemble it and assemble it by not looking at the spare part view, but sometimes it's easier and faster. Okay, so what we have now. Okay, the oil seal, the sleeve, the hammer. Now this one. Then the rubber. Of course, you can see that's the flat side of the rubber, and this is not a flat, it has the corner, round corner. The round corner goes on the front. Now this one. Okay. Of course, we need to grease it. Okay, I recommend to use the genuine Makita grease. Now I'm using another genuine Makita grease, but don't use it. Just don't use it. Okay. Just pushing the hammer with all parts inside. Okay, so check. Okay, yes, I have the aluminum cylinder. I will check it fit. Okay, it really fit. Now I need to push it with something. Okay, I will try to hit it with a hammer. Why I'm doing that? I want to put all the parts inside. and see what happens. Okay, so now they're looking good. Checking the hammer. Okay, because don't forget that we need to install the spring ring and it need to be in a groove out there. So it's really easier to do that with aluminum cylinder. Of course, if you will be very gentle, you can use the cylinder from the tool. Just don't smash it or break it, because you will need a new one. Okay. Now we have the cylinder for that purpose, that I can hammer. Okay, I will check it's in or not. Not okay. I will take it on a hydraulic press to press it, not to hammer. Of course, you can hammer it on, take it to the vise and press it. It's not a big problem, really not a big. Okay, I will be back shortly. Of course, it's a mess like always in my workshop. Okay, just press it a little bit, take the cylinder. Okay, we can see that the spring ring is in a groove here, so is everything good? Yes, we are lucky. Okay, so now, what now? Coffee break. Okay, after the video. So, now we can grease the striker. Of course, grease it, not too much. Okay, we can put some grease here, or you can insert grease inside here, so no difference if you put it here or here, so it still will be inside. Okay, of course, don't put too much grease, it's not very good for the tool. Okay, so what I need now, I can start to disassemble this one. Okay, I can see that I have a flat washer here. I need to install it on the cylinder. Then I need to install the spring. After the spring goes the gear. You can see that it's a grooves here. So for gear T's here. Okay, and of course it's a O-ring, that tiny O-ring, it must go here on a groove, it's a groove here for the O-ring, and this O-ring holds all parts on the cylinder, so, okay, it's held. Okay. I will put some grease inside the cylinder, to grease it better. Okay. So what we have bolts here, the cap, the spring, the housing. Okay, we'll put some grease here in our housing. Of course, not a lot of grease. Okay, if you need Makita grease, you can easily buy it on eBay from me, or you can buy it not from me. It's honestly, it's no different. Okay, so now I think I've installed the connection rod with the aluminum cylinder. Of course, I will grease it here all around. Why I'm greasing it? Because it's moving in a metal here. Yeah, of course, I put the grease here, but still, it's better to grease all parts. Okay, it's here the needle bearing. So we need to get it on this one, on the pin here. So, I will try to do that. Of course, if you will repair that same tool, you will do that. Honestly, I am very happy when someone is writing that they repaired their tool by watching my videos. So, yeah, it's really, I don't know, good feeling to help for others. Okay, just greasing the gears. Of course, the genuine Makita grease is in other consistencies, so it will be a little harder to grease it like that, but it's still able. Okay, need some paper. So now inserting the cylinder here. I will check if it's fit good or not. Okay, it's fit. We can see that it's moving with the gear here. So okay, my glove. Fuck my glove. It cost me a money. Of course, not a lot of money. Okay. The new gloves. If you are working with a greasy part, you really need the gloves. I know that sometimes it's harder to take the parts or feel something with them, but your hands are clean after the work, so I think it's definitely worth it. Okay, let's check. Okay. Why are you not going in? Okay. So you fit here or not? Okay, now it's fit. Okay, so I will clean it a little bit because touching it with a greasy hands, dirty hands. Okay, so what we have here is you need to find the four same length screws. Okay, don't screw the one screw to the end, just screw one, and don't, when screwing this, start from the different corners. Of course, now we need to check it with our hands, so about the strength, how much you need to tighten it. I don't know, I'm feeling that with a hand. Of course, if you're really interested in that, I can look in the Makita service program for that. Okay, but I think it's not a big difference. Okay. Of course, not a big difference on this part. Sometimes on the tools it's really important how hard you tighten the bolts. Okay, the hook can go now to the box. Other friends. Okay. So now inserting the grease here. Cleaning the housing. Okay, now we need to insert the armature with a torque limiter. Okay, they're in here. So, taking the motor housing, putting the armature in it, pressing it or heating slightly. Okay, it's screws to the plastic. Of course, it's a PH2 screw, so I need to change the bit. Okay, so we have the hole here. Fuck the hole. Okay, putting the grease here inside. Of course, cleaning a little bit. And closing the cap. Okay, I'm spinning into the unscrewing direction to get it in the right position and then screwing it in. Okay, so four holes here. You can use the pliers like this for screwing it. Okay, so maybe this one is too small. Okay. You can use this one, I think. Okay, yeah. To tighten it a little bit, so. Okay, don't tighten it too hard, because it's a plastic going to the aluminum, so it's definitely the plastic will fail, so don't use too much force. Okay, now I will install the carbon brushes. Okay, so what we have here, so it's a cover, it's a handle here. Okay, I'm missing the housing here because it was bring on the repair without the housing, but the customer told that he have the housing and we'll put it itself. Of course, it's not a problem for me. Okay, so what we can do now, we can connect the handle. Of course. So go take some paper out from here. Okay, so now about the connection. Of course, the small connection goes to the small. You can put it in a place here. Okay, so now the white and black wires here. And the orange and the pink. Just don't mess up with the colors. Okay, and closing the handle. Okay, so the handle is closed. So now the screws for the metal goes here on the top. Okay, so screws for the plastic goes here on the bottom. Okay. Lazy Bosch drill, not holding the drill bit. sorry. Okay, the bigger screw, you can see that we have the small screw and a bigger one. The bigger one goes to the handle. Small ones. Okay, sorry, forgot the spring for the handle. Why you not told that to me? Okay. So you can see that the handle without the spring is not moving back normally. Okay, so I will put it in. Okay, the spring must be here. So putting it in and closing the handle. We can see now the handle is popping back when we are pressing it. It's an anti-vibration system. It saves your health. Save your health. And really for me it's a different, it is or not. Then when I'm using the tool I'm feeling that, so okay, now the cover. So two screws here, the RP two screws too. Just don't forget that these screws are thinner and smaller than these screws used in a handle. Okay, so now you just spinning it to get it fit. Okay, it fit. Okay, checking if it's working. Okay, it's working. Now the screw, the customer lost the screw, so I'm screwing it in the housing. It will hold the plastic cover. Just screwing it with my hand. Okay, so now we need to check the tool, is it's working or not. Okay, the drilling mode is working, the toilet direction is working too. Okay, the hammer, you can see that the hammer go out. Okay, now only hammering. Okay, one of the way to check it, if you don't have the tool holder like this, you can press it to the puncher here and it will hit to the puncher. Of course you can put the tool holder on and check it on a wood, on a concrete or something else. So thank you for watching. This was a Makita rotary hammer drill HR2811FT with changeable tool holder. We changed the cylinder, the o-ring, of course the grease. So it's a great tool, and thank you for watching. Of course thank you for commenting on my videos, and see you in my next videos. Bye.